Everyone loves burgers, whether it's a full-stack burger, a front-end burger, or a back-end burger. While the origin of this burger is unknown, a comparable full-stack burger was shared on Reddit 4 years ago, and a similar back-end burger was posted on dev.to in 2021. We'd like to give a special shout-out to the original creators. In this video, we'll share our favorite choices for each of the ingredients in our version of the back-end burger. Our choices are different for different stages of a company. For this particular exercise, we'll focus on an early stage startup where there are limited resources and product market fit is not yet certain. In this scenario, maximum flexibility is preferred. Starting from the top, for containerization, we choose nothing. To maintain maximum flexibility, we'll probably go with serverless functions. Serverless functions have a very strict request-response programming model, but under the hood, most serverless functions are packaged as a container. For architectural patterns, serverless is our first choice. With serverless computing, we only pay for the resources we use, and we don't have to worry about provisioning, scaling, or maintaining servers. This frees up time and resources to focus on product features. For CI/CD, we'll use GitHub Actions. There's no need to set up our own CI/CD at such an early stage. For API, yes, we'll use REST. REST is the standard between client and server. For version control systems, or VCS, GitHub is fine. For caching, browser cache and CDN are by far the most important to improve user experience. CDN comes for free with most hosting providers like Vercel and Netlify. If not, just use Cloudflare. For frameworks, we'll use something like Next.js and host both front and back end on something like Vercel. This means the back end is going to be in Express with TypeScript on the back end. Now, this is great, one language for both front end and back end. For testing, this is going to be controversial. We don't need testing for early stage startups other than very simple unit tests. When we found product market fit and start to scale the company, we'll invest in more testing. We promise. As we already discussed, a language would be TypeScript for both front-end and back-end. Finally, database. If we're storing very simple data, we would use something hosted like Firebase or Firestore. If our data model is more complicated, we'll use a serverless relational database like Aurora Serverless. Well, this is a fun little exercise. I hope you agree with most of our choices. Feel free to comment and share your opinions. If you like our videos, you might like our system design newsletter as well. It covers topics and trends in large-scale system design, trusted by 280,000 readers. Subscribe at blog.bybygo.com.